your girl Mahalia J and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is my everyday makeup routine. I recently got some new products from Sephora. Since I've been using them, I've had so many people ask me,
what are you doing different? How do you do this? How do you do that? You need a makeup routine. You need a makeup routine.
Here it is, wait no more, the long-awaited makeup routine. So I'm not gonna do too much talking. I'm just gonna get right into the video. Hey my loves, so I'm gonna go ahead and start with my brows. For my brows, I use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Pomade in the color Granite. For the brush that I use for my brows, I use Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow with a spoolie on one end and an angled brush on the other. I believe this brush is number 12. I'm just going to take a bit of product and start with the very top of my brows. Then I underline the bottom, but I make sure I'm very light-handed with this technique because I do not like boxy brows. And then I go into the tail. I barely put any product in the beginning of my brows because I naturally have very full brows. And if I do put product in the very beginning of my brows, it just gets very boxy and I just don't like that look. I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing on the other side. I use my concealer to shape up my brows the way that I actually want them to look, but right now they look crazy as hell. So for my concealer, I use the Too Faced Born This Way concealer in the shade Butterscotch. For the concealer brush I use a flat brush. This brush is from shopmissa.com and it's the AOA Studio. I think it's called E115. I start from the bottom and I carve my brows. I make sure I'm very careful with this step because I don't want to get any concealer in my brows. And then I bring the concealer down to help me blend it out. They literally don't even look related at this point. Anyways, I use this brush. I don't know the name of this brush, but I know it's from e.l.f. Take it and I blend the concealer around my brows. I also make sure that I take my time while blending and I don't get any of the concealer into my eyebrows, because once they do, I feel like it just looks extremely ashy. If anything has to be sharp on your face, it has to be your brows. Let's be real. Before I start my foundation, I'm gonna go in with the Hydro Milk Makeup Primer. I just put about 2 pumps on each side. And then I go ahead and rub that in. One thing I can say about this primer is that it does the job. It literally leaves my foundation and my base as a whole looking so flawless. Going in with my Too Faced Born This Way foundation in the shade Chestnut. I'm gonna apply 2 full pumps on each cheek and wipe the excess off. The foundation brush that I use is also from Shop Miss A. It's the AOA Studio. It's the High Def Brush F1. I'm going to spray my brush with my Urban Decay All Nighter Spray. Can you focus? Okay, I don't want to focus. I'm sure y'all know what it looks like. I'm gonna spray it just a bit and just blend that in. And also make sure I blend my foundation into my neck. That is probably the most important step. You don't want to go and take pictures and then your neck is looking like one color and your face is looking like another. That's not cute. So I go in and I make sure that my foundation is blending in with my concealer. Next, I am going to do my concealer, and I actually use 3 2.5 concealers for this step. Y'all will see in a minute, but I go in with the same Too Faced Born This Way concealer that I use for my brows for right here and right here. I don't know if y'all have seen that like little TikTok makeup hack, but I've literally incorporated that into my makeup routine because it just makes my face look 10 times better than what I was doing before. But it's when you put concealer like in the corners of your eye and right here, it basically gives you like a facelift. And since this concealer is a bit bright, I go in with my Stay Naked Correcting Concealer in the shade 70WG. Y'all probably can't see that. I put it right under to kind of like make the blending process a little bit easier for me because it looks the same color on camera, but I promise you it's a bit warmer. The brush that I use to blend in my concealer is my Milk makeup brush from Sephora. Come on, focus. You see it? Focus. Thank you very much. Transfer the brush. Literally after every single time I blend anything cream based, I always spray my brush with setting spray before I blend because it just helps it last longer. I start with the inner corners of my under eye and I blend it out into my cheekbones. And then I also put some on my eyes, my eyelid. I love that. I love the way it's looking. Blend the concealer on my chin, my forehead. I have a very small forehead, so I'm pretty generous when it comes to concealer on my forehead. And then my nose. And that's that. So this right here is my swag. Anyways, this right here is the holy grail tip that I recommend everyone to start doing. If you want that like absolute bright under eye, you need to start doing this because everybody has bags, okay? I don't know one person who gets 8 hours of sleep every night. I don't. I can tell you that. I use the Urban Decay All Nighter foundation actually. This is actually a sample size that I got a while ago. And ever since I've been using this, I've literally been in love. But I use this and I put it right on my under eyes. I take the Milk Makeup Concealer, angled concealer brush, and I blend that out. I just use this just to blend it in a little bit. It just makes it easier for me to blend everything out once I'm done. So I take the concealer brush that I was using before. I spray it with some all-nighter setting spray. I just blend everything out. Next, I go in with my Fenty Beauty setting powder. It's in the shade Hazelnut. I actually use two setting powders because this one is a bit too brown for me, but I just use this to set before I really set. I just kind of tap it into my skin before I apply my contour and brush it off. And then a bit on my chin, some of my nose, and a bit on my forehead. Make sure I always get some in my eyes. I set everywhere that I applied concealer. I didn't apply concealer here, but you know, just to give your cheekbones a little extra lift. So once I set my face, I go in with my contour. I go in with my Hoola Toasted Bronzer by Benefit with this Sephora angled brush, bronzer brush. And I blend it in, put some on my jawline. I also put some on my nose and then some right here. Next, I'm going to wipe off my setting powder with the Milk brush. And I believe this is called, what is it called? It's just called setting powder. So I'll go ahead and wipe off all the excess powder. So next I'm gonna go in with my other setting powder, and it's the Huda Beauty setting powder in the shade Blondie. This stuff, holy grail. Not only does it make your face look so flawless, but it smells good as hell. It literally smells like perfume. I apply some under my eyes. I apply some on my chin and my forehead. And then lastly, I get my nose. So while my face is baking, I'm gonna go ahead and do my bronzer and my blush. I'm going to be using my Hoola Toasted as well as my NARS blush in the shade Exhibit A. And what I do is I mix these two together. You see how beautiful that is? That's like the perfect combination that nobody talks about. Honestly, truthfully, people don't put bronzer right here, but I like to make sure that my face is as warm as possible because I look like a ghost right now. So yeah, it just combats the brightness. Put some down my bridge. I'm gonna go in with my Fenty Beauty bronzer in the shade Mocha Mommy. And I actually use this for my eyeshadow because, as I said earlier, I just like it when my face is extremely warm. It just adds the bronzer. It just makes you look 10 times better. I'm gonna go back in with my setting powder brush and brush out the excess setting powder. And then once I'm done with my face, I usually go back and I define my brows just a bit more, just in case it was, you know, messed with during my base process. I like it when my tail is extremely sharp and defined, so I really just go over my brows at the very end. I use the All Nighter setting spray and I set my face. Now I'm going to do my highlight. Highlight that I use is so old, I really do not remember where I got this from. The brush that I use for my highlight is the tapered highlight brush from Ulta Beauty. Put it on the very tip of my nose and the very top of the bridge of my nose. Blend that in a little bit. Put some on my Cupid's bow as well. And then I just put a very small amount on my cheekbones. I put a very small amount in the corners of my eyes. I use this curved brush. I don't remember where it's from. I just apply a teensy bit under my brows just to make my brows pop. I'm going to go ahead and put some glue. I use the Duo Glue. I got these lashes off of AliExpress. These are probably my favorite pair of lashes, but I'm going to go ahead and apply some glue on these and set these aside so I can do my lips. And I use the, y'all, this lip liner. Who's next? Because this lip liner, listen, Miss Charlotte Tilbury, you done did the damn thing. And it's called the Lip Cheat in the color Pillow Talk. Sucky sucky now. It just glides on so smooth. The fact that I still have like chapstick on my lips and it's still gliding on this smooth, I'm gonna go and buy four more. For my lip glosses, I use the Fenty Beauty lip gloss in the shade Sweet Mouth. And I use that just for my main lip color. And then I go in with my NYX Butter Gloss Fortune Cookie. Just dab this on the middle of my bottom lip and the middle of my top lip. I'm gonna go ahead and apply that there. Yeah, these are my favorite lashes for a reason. Are we done here? Ooh, no, we're not. You can never have too much bronzer. I really just use the excess off this brush just to bronze my face up some more. And that's it. This is the finished look. So that's it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. If y'all like this video and want more like this, let me know in the comments down below. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video.